نجاتنا فتمسكي بعواه كي لا نغرقا.
Okay. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Respected viewers, welcome back again after the show break. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of our good deeds. We'll go to our contestant inshallah. But before that, let me thank you. Jazakallah khair to our beloved Sheikh Qadi Lutfur Rahman for the recitation inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it inshallah. Amen. So without further delaying, we'll be calling upon our reciters and contestants inshallah. So first of all, let's call Abdullah Numan Al-Madani, 18 years old from Ilford.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Abdullah Numan, how are you today?
Alhamdulillah.
MashaAllah, your smile is telling us that you're confident and very good.
Yeah, alhamdulillah.
InshaAllah. So you've got 7 minutes for the recitations. So what surah you've chosen?
Surah Al-Hujurat.
Surah Al-Hujurat, MashaAllah. So if you can take the microphone a bit closer. Yes, inshallah. So when you're ready, you can begin with your recitation.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله واتقوا الله إن الله سميع عليم يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا ترفعوا أصواتكم فوق صوت النبي ولا تجهروا له بالقول كجهر بعضكم لبعض أن تحبط أعمالكم وأنتم لا تشعرون إن الذين يغضون أصواتهم عند رسول الله أولئك الذين امتحن الله قلوبهم للتقوى لهم مغفرة وأجر عظيم إن الذين ينادونك من وراء أكثرهم لا يعقلون ولو أنهم صبروا حتى تخرج إليهم لكان خيرا لهم والله غفور رحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا فاسق بنبأ فتبينوا أن تصيبوا قوما بجهالة فتصبحوا على ما فعلتم نادمين واعلموا أن فيكم رسول الله لو يطيعكم في كثير من الأمر لعنتم ولكن الله حبب إليكم الإيمان وزينه في قلوبكم وكره إليكم الكفر والفسوق والعصيان أولئك هم الراشدون فضلا من الله ونعمة والله عليم حكيم وإن طائفة رجلتان من المؤمنين اقتتلوا فأصلحوا بينهما فإن بغت إحداهما على الأخرى فقاتلوا التي تبغي حتى تفيء إلى أمر الله فإن فاءت فأصلحوا بينهما بالعدل وأقسطوا إن الله يحب المقسطين إنما المؤمنون إخوة فأصلحوا بين أخويكم واتقوا الله لعلكم ترحمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا يسخر قوم من قوم عسى أن يكونوا خيرا منهم ولا نساء من نساء عسى أن يكن خيرا منهن ولا تلمزوا أنفسكم ولا تنابزوا بالألقاب بئس الاسم الفسوق بعد الإيمان ومن لم يتب فأولئك هم الظالمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن إن بعض الظن إثم ولا تجسسوا ولا يغتب بعضكم بعضا أيحب أحدكم أن يأكل لحم أخيه ميتا فكرهتموه واتقوا الله إن الله تواب رحيم صدق الله العظيم
أحسنت جزاك الله خير عبد الله نمان may Allah accept your recitation inshallah so the judges will ask you questions it will be four questions from the tajweed rules so I would start with Sheikh Qadi Lutf al-Rahman for your question
inshallah. One question each judges
Oh, that's fine. And there will be four questions okay. So I'll pick another
okay that's fine كثيرا من الظن كثيرا من الظن what's the ruling of tajweed here
إضغام مع الغنة
great ما شاء الله excellent
ما شاء الله جزاك الله خير أستاذ محمد بدر
So in the verse, فَإِنْ بَغَتْ إِحْدَاهُمَا What are the rules there?
So, فَإِمْ So after ميم ساكن came a ba, So which is going to
is
be
it, Is it after ميم ساكن?
فَإِمْ
Fun to give you the breakdown, it's فَإِنْ
بَغَتْ oh, Sorry, yeah, فَإِنْ بَغَتْ Sorry, it's إِقْلَاب
What's happened in a club?
So after Nun Sakin or Tanween, also in this case Nun Sakin, came a ba. So you change the ba into a, so you change the Nun into a meme.
And how do you do the ada of the meme here? Is it a full pronunciation of the meme?
So you know some say it's half so fa'in, so it's okay. Slightly blurred sound or you can
okay.
say.
Okay, good. And what about Baghat? Tell me something about the ta here, in the manner of its articulation.
Oh, the ta.
Yes.
The ta is pronounced when the tip of the tongue, is you wanted the articulation, yeah. When the tip of the tongue rises and touches the gums of the upper front two teeth.
Okay, thank you.
Or incises, yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, JazakAllah khair. Sheikh Anhar Ahmed.
Okay, mashallah, excellent recitation, well done. Your third question لعنت من الأمر لعنتم ولكن so what is the rule that takes place between لعنتم ولكن in between the two words? لعنتم ولكن.
لعنتم. So that's a ميم ساكن, and then it's ولكن. So it's going to be إظهار شفوي.
Good. Why is it إظهار شفوي?
Because after ميم ساكن, it's not either باء or ميم.
Okay. ما شاء الله. Well done.
Okay. Inshallah. جزاك الله خير. One more question left. So Sheikh Qadi Lutfur Rahman, if you can.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا يسخر قوم لا يسخر. Is there any ruling?
لا يسخر. So in the ra, you'd make that full mouth.
Yeah, that's good. Great. Okay, لا sure. يسخر. Yeah.
Okay. جزاك الله خير عبد الله نعمان for your answers and for the recitation. Inshallah. In terms of the speech, what is the topic you've chosen?
The importance of the Quran.
The importance of the Quran. Mashallah. So you've got 4 minutes for that. Inshallah. When you're ready, you can begin.
الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له من اتقاه وتوكل عليه جعل له من كل هم فرجا ومن كل ضيق مخرجا وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اتخذ القرآن سبيلا إلى ربه ومنهجا صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد. Respected audience, my fellow Qurra, our presenter and judges, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, here we are after 1400 years in this very gathering for the sake of a blessing that was bestowed upon us, such that we are of the final ummah, the ummah of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we know that there were many prophets before him, and they were given miracles that left with them. But our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was given the Quran, the miracle of the Quran, which remains eternal. And it was revealed by Allah Azza wa Jal, the Lord of the universe, whose words are most superior. Tanzeelun min Rabbil Alameen. And it was revealed through the trustworthy and noble angel. Nazala bihi ar-ruhul amin. And it was revealed in the best of months. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. And it was revealed to the best of mankind. كتاب أنزلناه إليك لتخرج الناس من الظلمات إلى النور. And this Quran is so powerful and so great that Allah Azza wa Jal mentions in Surah Al-Hashr, لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. If we had sent this Quran upon a mountain, you'd have seen it humbled and coming apart from the fear of Allah. Now after having such a great blessing, how many of us are fulfilling its rights and how many of us are acting upon it? And do we realize and recognize its value? The Quran, which could be for us or against us on the Day of Judgment. As our beloved Prophet ﷺ said, Al-Quran hujjatun laka aw alayka. The Quran will be for you or against you. And now, today, we should be grateful that we could see young people striving to perfect their Quran. And they are encouraged by such opportunities to perform and to show their talent. And it pushes them so much, and it pushes them so far that they can deliver at the highest standards. And of course, their honor would be through the honor of the Quran. And Imam Muslim mentions in his Sahih, and Abi Umamah al-Bahili radiallahu anhu qal, سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمَ يَقُولُ اقْرَأُوا الْقُرْآنَ فَإِنَّهُ يَأْتِي يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ شَفِيعًا لِأَصْحَابِهِ. Abu Umamah al-Bahili radiallahu anhu reports that he heard Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, read the Quran, for it will intercede for its reader on the Day of Judgment. SubhanAllah. This Quran, in the eyes of Allah, is so great and so important that just by simply reciting it, it could be a source, it could be a mean of intercession, of shafa'ah for us, inshaAllah. And this Quran is such a blessing that it is for everyone, no matter who you are. And it guides. And it's like a traveler's guide. So long as you follow it, you won't be lost. As Allah Azza wa Jal mentions in Surah Al-Isra,
إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا كبيرا.
Indeed, this Quran guides to that which is most suitable and gives good tidings to the believers who do righteous deeds, that they will have a great reward. Allahumma ja'alna minhum. May Allah make us amongst them.
Amen.
And I'd like to mention a hadith by Anas ibn Malik. Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu qal, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inna lillahi ahlina min al-nas. Qalu ya Rasulullah, man hum? Qal, hum ahlul Qur'an, ahlullahi wa khasatuh. Sahih ibn Majah. The Messenger of Allah, peace and blessings be upon him, said, Allah has his own people among mankind. They asked, O Messenger of Allah, who are they? He replied, they are the people of the Qur'an, the people of Allah, and those who are closest to him. Allahumma ja'ala minhum. May Allah make us amongst them. And for us to really become the people of the Qur'an, we should practice upon another hadith of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as mentioned in Sahih al-Bukhari. عن عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه. The best amongst you are the ones who learn the Quran and teach it to others. Now if we could all try our best to learn the Quran ourselves, encourage our friends, our family, and especially our younger ones, and teach them to the best of our ability. Let us continue our journey with the Quran as the blessed month of Ramadan is approaching. We should try our best to, you know, do tilawah as much as we can and act upon the Qur'an. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the tawfiq to have great understanding of the importance of the Qur'an and to fulfill its rights and to gain maximum benefit. Allahumma aj'alil Qur'ana rabi'a qulubina wa nura sudurina wa jala'a ahzanina. Allahumma aj'alil Qur'ana hujjatan lana wa la taj'alu hujjatan alayna. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يقرأه فيرقى ولا تجعلنا ممن يقرأه فيزل ويشقى. هذا وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
Okay, inshallah. Jazakallah khair for your speech. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to act upon whatever you said, inshallah. Jazakallah khair, inshallah. Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. Okay, alhamdulillah, respected viewers, we've listened to a beautiful recitation from Abdullah Nu'man. Jazakallah khair. We'll be calling upon next contestant, Habib Matlib from Swansea.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Habib, how are you today?
Alhamdulillah, I'm fine.
Inshallah, you confident and ready?
Inshallah.
For the recitation, you've got 7 minutes, and for the speech, you will get 4 minutes, inshallah. So make sure you maintain the time when you're reciting and while you're giving your speech. So what surah you've chosen for the recitation?
I'm going to do in the end part of Surah Tawbah.
End part of Surah Tawbah, mashallah. So lift the mic a bit up, so for the recitation. Okay, inshallah. So when you're ready, Habib, you can begin with your recitation.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله اشترى من المؤمنين أنفسهم وأموالهم بأن لهم الجنة يقاتلون في سبيل الله فيقتلون ويقتلون وعدا عليه حقا في التوراة والإنجيل والقرآن ومن أوفى بعهده من الله فاستبشروا ببيعكم الذي بايعتم به وذلك هو الفوز العظيم التائبون العابدون الحامدون السائحون السائحون الراكعون الساجدون الآمرون بالمعروف والناهون عن المنكر والحافظون لحدود الله وبشر المؤمنين ما كان للنبي والذين آمنوا أن يستغفروا للمشركين ولو كانوا أولي قربى من بعد ما تبين لهم أنهم أصحاب الجحيم وما كان استغفار إبراهيم لأبيه إلا عن موعدة وعدها إياه فلما تبين له أنه عدو لله تبرأ منه إن إبراهيم لأواه حليم وما كان الله ليضل قوما بعد إذ هداهم حتى يبين لهم ما يتقون إن الله بكل شيء عليم إن الله له ملك السماوات والأرض يحيي ويميت وما لكم من دون الله من ولي ولا نصير لقد تاب الله على النبي والمهاجرين والأنصار الذين اتبعوه في ساعة العسرة من بعد ما كاد يزيغ قلوب فريق منهم ثم تاب عليهم إنه بهم رؤوف رحيم وعلى الثلاثة الذين خلفوا حتى إذا ضاقت عليهم الأرض بما رحبت وضاقت عليهم أنفسهم وظنوا أن لا ملجأ من الله إلا إليه ثم تاب عليهم ليتوبوا إن الله هو التواب الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين ما كان لأهل المدينة ومن حولهم من الأعراب أن يتخلفوا عن رسول الله ولا يرغبوا بأنفسهم عن نفسه ذلك بأنهم لا يصيبهم ظمأ ولا نصب ولا مخمصة في سبيل الله ولا يطؤون موطئا يغيظ الكفار ولا ينالون من عدو نيلا من عدو نيلا إلا كتب لهم به عمل صالح إن الله لا يضيع أجر المحسنين ولا ينفقون نفقة صغيرة ولا كبيرة ولا يقطعون واديا إلا كتب لهم ليجزيهم الله أحسن ما كانوا يعملون صدق الله مولانا العظيم.
أحسن جزاك الله خير حبيب مطلب for the beautiful recitation. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى accept it. So are you ready for the questions you will be asked by the judges?
Inshallah.
Inshallah. So I would start with Ustad Muhammad Badr for you to say your question. Inshallah.
Just quickly, if you can briefly tell me the rules in وما لكم من دون الله من ولي ولا نصير.
وما لكم It's maddul asli because before an alif, وما لكم, because an alif is zabr before an alif, وما لكم من دون الله. It is idgham saghir mithlain because after a mim sakin, a mim came up. So وما لكم من دون الله is akhfa because after noon sakin. Min dunillahi is one of the 15 letters of ikhfa.
What do you do in ikhfa? Explain to
you,
me.
You have to do ghunna, so you have to hide it. You know.
Hide the
letter.
Which?
Malakum min. So you have to hide the noon in your nose.
Okay.
Malakum min du. Du is going to be maddul asli. Because before and wow is a pesh, min dunillahi, it's going to be an empty mouth because there's a zer before and
okay.
Allah.
Thank you.
Okay, jazakallah khair. Ustad Anhar Ahmed.
Okay, can you give me four situations where the letter ra will be read with thick sound? Give me four
thick
situations.
Thick sound, full mouth.
Full mouth, yes.
Okay, so before when there's a ra and there's a zabar on top of it, when there's a ra sakin and there's a pesh or a zabar on when there's a ra sakin and the letter before has a zabar or a pesh, and when in the end of a ayah, when if there's a zubur or a pesh and the ra, and lastly
you mentioned fatha already, so dhamma at the end, you're saying
okay inshallah jazakallah khair. Sheikh Qadil Lutfur Rahman, your question.
Mashallah, beautiful recitation. An yastaghfiru if you can just tell me the rulings.
Yeah, that's al idgham with unna. Because afternoon second is yeah.
Okay. And then yastaghfiru, is there any?
Yastaghfiru. The ra is going to be full mouth.
Yeah. There's one more.
Yes. Yastagh.
Yeah. So ghain as well. When you say yastagh, say yastaghfiru.
Yeah. It's going to be full mouth.
As well, yeah?
Yeah.
So yastaghfiru. Yeah. Okay. That's fine. Thank you.
Okay, inshallah. Jazakallah khair. One more question by Ustad Muhammad Badr, inshallah.
Oh, God. So again, just to add on to what Sheikh said, so when you mentioned that, you can just explain to me that what is idgham here and what's happened here?
Okay, so after nun sakin or tanween, if one of the letters of idgham comes, that is ya wa mim nun, if it comes, then you have to join the letter before that, you have to join the letters.
So explain to me in the context of ayn yastaghfiru, what joins onto what?
So the alif is joining with ya.
Okay, inshallah. Okay, jazakallah khair, Habib. For the speech, what topic you've chosen?
Dua, the greatest weapon of a Muslim.
Okay, inshallah. You've got 4 minutes for your speech, inshallah. If the time goes up, I'll give you a second. When you're ready, you can start.
الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear respected judges, ulamas, huffaz, and respected elders, my fellow peers and all of the viewers who are watching this live program today, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon us all. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, first of all thanks and praise belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us the tawfiq to be here today in this beautiful gathering. After my semi-finals, I practiced a lot, and I did something so simple, yet it had a profound effect. I made dua. Alhamdulillah, my dua was accepted, and here I am today in the finals. Brothers and sisters, as I am going to talk about dua today, I would like to start off my speech with a dua that Allah mentions in the Quran, Surah Taha, ayah number 25. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Allah teaches us to say this dua. O my Lord, expand my chest, ease my task for me, and remove the impediment from my speech so they may understand what I say. Brothers and sisters, we should all do this dua before we do anything. Dua is a tool that we all have at our disposal, yet we hardly seem to use. Many of us have a doubt in our minds, even when we do dua. We think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might not accept the dua. We think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might not forgive me. No, my brothers and sisters, listen what Allah says in the Quran, Surah Baqarah, ayah number 186. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ.
And when my servant asks you concerning me, tell them, I am indeed close to them, and I listen to the prayer of every suppliant who calls upon me. There's no doubt about that. Brothers and sisters, if you ask your parents for a chocolate, the first time, they might give you the chocolate. After 10 minutes, if you ask them again, if they are feeling in a good mood, they might give you the chocolate. But the third time, if you ask them again, they might give you a slap instead. This is human nature. But brothers and sisters, the more you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more happy He is. Listen to this hadith. عن أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه عن نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ليس شيء أكرم على الله تعالى من الدعاء. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhum narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, there is nothing more honorable to in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than dua. But what do we do, brothers and sisters? We ask our parents for more than we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many times do we cry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Listen to this other hadith. وعن أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول والله إني لاستغفر الله وأتوب إليه في اليوم أكثر من 70 مرة. Abu Huraira رضي الله عنهم narrated that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, I swear, I supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than 70 times a day, subhanallah. Now, brothers and sisters, if the best creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than 70 times a day, what are we doing, brothers and sisters? When was the last time we sincerely asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness?
We've got 10 more seconds.
When was the last time we let our tears from our eyes in dua? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our ibadah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to do more ibadah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon us all. Wa akhiru da'wana in alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Inshallah, beautiful. Jazakallah khair for the reminder you've given us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of our du'as and give us the tawfiq, inshallah.
Okay. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Respected viewers, I'm sure you are enjoying the recitations and the speeches as well. So we'll be calling upon our next contestant, Hamidul Islam, from London.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, Islam, how are you today?
Alhamdulillah, how are you?
Inshallah, you confident? Alhamdulillah, yeah, I'm good. Alhamdulillah. Confident?
Yeah.
Inshallah, what surah you have picked up for the recitation?
Suratul Qalam.
Suratul Qalam, inshallah. You've got 7 minutes for the recitation. Then after that, the judges will ask you 4 questions. So when you're ready, Hamidul Islam, you can begin with your recitation.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نون والقلم وما يسطرون ما أنت بنعمة ربك بمجنون وإن لك لأجرا غير ممنون وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم فستبصر ويبصرون بأيكم المفتون إن ربك هو أعلم بمن ضل عن سبيله وهو أعلم بالمهتدين فلا تطع المكذبين ودوا لو تدهن فيدهنون ولا تطع كل حلاف مهين هماز مشاء بنميم مناع للخير معتد أثيم عتل بعد ذلك زنيم أن كان ذا مال وبنين إذا تتلى عليه آياتنا قال أساطير الأولين سنسمه على الخرطوم إنا بلوناهم كما بلونا أصحاب الجنة إذ أقسموا ليصرمنها مصبحين ولا يستثنون فطاف عليها طائف من ربك وهم نائمون فأصبحت كالصريم فتنادوا مصبحين أن اغدوا على حرثكم إن كنتم صارمين فانطلقوا وهم يتخافتون ألا يدخلنها اليوم عليكم مسكين وغدوا على حرد قادرين فلما رأوها قالوا إنا لضالون بل نحن محرومون قال أوسطهم ألم أقل لكم لولا تسبحون قالوا سبحان ربنا إنا كنا ظالمين فأقبل بعضهم على بعض يتلاومون قالوا يا ويلنا إنا كنا طاغين عسى ربنا أن يبدلنا خيرا منها إنا إلى ربنا راغبون كذلك العذاب ولعذاب الآخرة أكبر لو كانوا يعلمون إن للمتقين عند ربهم جنات النعيم أفنجعل المسلمين كالمجرمين ما لكم كيف تحكمون أم لكم كتاب فيه تدرسون إن لكم فيه لما تخيرون أم لكم أيمان علينا بالغة إلى يوم القيامة إن لكم لما تحكمون سلهم أيهم بذلك زعيم أم لهم شركاء فليأتوا بشركائهم إن كانوا صادقين يوم يكشف عن ساق ويدعون إلى السجود فلا يستطيعون خاشعة أبصارهم ترهقهم ذلة وقد كانوا يدعون إلى السجود وهم سالمون فذني ومن يكذب بهذا الحديث سنستدرجهم من حيث لا يعلمون وأملي لهم إن كيدي متين أم تسألهم أجرا فهم من مغرم مثقلون أم عندهم الغيب فهم يكتبون فاصبر لحكم ربك ولا تكن كصاحب الحوت إذ نادى وهو مكظوم لولا أن تداركه نعمة من ربه لنبذ بالعراء وهو مذموم فاجتباه ربه فجعله من الصالحين وإن يكاد الذين كفروا ليزلقونك بأبصارهم لما سمعوا الذكر ويقولون إنه لمجنون وما هو إلا ذكر للعالمين عالمين
أحسنت جزاك الله خير حامد الإسلام إن شاء الله brilliant recitation
صحيح
Okay, take your time. Okay, you ready for the questions?
Inshallah.
Inshallah. We'll start with Sheikh Anhar Ahmed.
MashaAllah, Hamidul Islam, you recited the whole of Surah Al-Qalam. MashaAllah, one of the verse you recited, فَطَافَ عَلَيْهَا طَائِفٌ مِّن رَبِّكْ So what's happening with the طَائِفٌ
مَدْ وَاجِبْ مُتَّسِلْ Because after the Mad letter, there's a hamza in the same word. So it must make this 3 to 5 counts long.
Okay, jazakallah.
Okay, inshallah, jazakallah khair. Ustad Muhammad Badr.
The verse, Hammazim Masha'in Binamim. What are the rules there?
Hamma is Akmal Ghunna because the meme has Shadda on top of it. It's also one alif long because it has a fatha on top of it and it's followed by Ahmad Alif. So it must make this one count long. Hamazim. Yallah. It's Adgham with Ghunna because after the Tanween Kasra, there's a meme, so you must merge it with Ghunna. Hamazim. Again, it's Akmal Ghunna because of the same reason. Hamazim Mashya. Mad Muttasil. Because after the Mad Alif, there's a Hamza in the same word. Hamazim Mashya. It's Iqlab, because after the Tanween Kasra there is a ba, so you must change the noon Tanween sound into a meme and make Ghunna on it.
How do you make Ghunna on it there? Like, what's the manner of articulation? How do you articulate that?
You say the meme makhrid, but not almost, like, it's not completely meme. So you just, like, most scholars say you should just leave a gap. In between your teeth.
Okay, jazakallah khair. Sheikh Qadil Tur Rahman, your question.
Okay, mashallah. Again, beautiful recitation. Just wanted to ask, فَلْيَأْتُوا بِشُرَكَائِهِمْ So, what are the ruling in بِشُرَكَائِهِمْ?
شُرَكَاء. Should I say all the words?
Yeah, just بِشُرَكَائِهِمْ, just that.
بِشُرَاء. رَاء is full mouth because it has a fatha.
Can you just say, like, بِشُرَاء? Can you just recite, بِ?
Oh, بشركائهم.
Yeah, make sure just more full mouth. بشرا شركاء. Okay.
Okay.
And then the next one.
The calf is 55 counts long. مد متصل. Because after the mad alif, there's a hamza in the same word. بشركائهم.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. Okay. Alhamdulillah.
Jazakallah khair. One more question by Sheikh Anhar Ahmed. Inshallah.
One of the words you recited, la dhalun.
Yeah.
Okay, so what are we doing in the dhad?
The dhad is mad lazim, kilmi muthakkal, because after the mad alif there's a letter, mushaddad letter. So you must make this mad 6 counts long. And I don't think there's anything else to say on that.
The letter dhad itself?
Oh, it's full mouth, quality of ishtiala.
Okay, good.
Mashallah. Okay, inshallah. Okay, jazakallah khair. Hamid al-Islam. Okay, you've got 4 minutes for the speech. So what is the topic you are going to speak about?
Knowledge.
Knowledge, inshallah. So make sure you maintain the time. And when you're ready, you can begin with your speech.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters, in Islam, elderly hosts, judges and viewers, I begin with the Islamic greeting, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My topic today is about something all of us here are coming to attain, but we may not have thought about how closely it is related to our religion. This something, my brothers and sisters, is knowledge. All of us here are coming to attain knowledge to inshallah lead us to become better people and Muslims. However, for many, this knowledge may lead to their downfall. They may become arrogant and start thinking that this knowledge that they are gaining is due to their own hard work. Allah says in the Quran, Surah An-Nahl, verse 78, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
وَاللَّهُ أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ.
And Allah has extracted you from the wombs of your mothers not knowing a thing. And He made for you hearing and vision and intellect that perhaps you would be grateful. Remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that gave you your brains, your health, the financial stability, the emotional stability, and every single blessing we can think of. However, the sad reality is that many of us forget about these blessings. And instead of using this knowledge to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we end up getting involved in things that displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is impossible for us to be good Muslims while we are in a state of ignorance, while we live in a state of ignorance. Our greatest danger lies in our ignorance of the Quran, the Islamic teachings, and what has been taught to us by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Knowledge is practiced and pursued with modesty and humility and leads to beauty and dignity, freedom and justice. Abu Huraira reported that the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, إِذَا مَاتَ الْإِنسَانُ قَطَعُ عَنْهُ عَمَلُهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثَةٍ إِلَّا مِنْ صَدَقَةٍ جَارِيَةٍ أَوْ عِلْمٍ يُنْتَفَعُ بِهِ أَوْ وَلَدٍ صَالِحٍ يَدْعُو لَهُ. When a man dies, all of his deeds come to an end except for free. An ongoing charity, beneficial knowledge, or a righteous son who will pray for him. Narrated a Muslim. The knowledge you gain is so sacred, and you should cherish the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you the honor to gain this knowledge. There is so much reward in attaining this knowledge if you do it for the right reasons and you respect and honor the knowledge. Allah says in the Quran, Surah Al-Mujadilah, verse 11, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
الله الذين آمنوا منكم والذين أوتوا العلم درجات والله بما تعملون خبير.
Allah will raise those who have believed among you and those who are given knowledge by degrees, and Allah is acquainted with what you do. Remember, the main purpose of acquiring knowledge, whatever type it may be, is to bring us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Throughout history, Muslims made glorious and marvelous achievements in almost every field of scientific knowledge, including astronomy, physics, chemistry, biology, social sciences, medicine, and so on and so on. However, it was not simply for the gratification of the mind or the senses. It was not knowledge for the sake of knowledge or gaining worldly pleasures. The bigger goal should not just be worldly comfort, but mainly that you want to enter Jannah by using the knowledge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with. to come closer to him and benefit others with. Abu Huraira reported that the Messenger of peace be upon him said, من سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما سهل الله له طريقا إلى الجنة. Whoever takes a path upon which to obtain knowledge, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes the path to path easy to paradise for him.
Islam, you've got 10 more seconds.
Okay, I would like to conclude. This was narrated in Damil Tirmidhi. I would like to conclude the speech by saying, the knowledge you gain, it can be a means of entering Jannah. But what counts is your attitude towards this knowledge, your concern for your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and your passion to spread the message of the truth to those around you. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wa salamun ala al-musaleen wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. May Allah grant us knowledge and the ability to use it wisely.
Ameen, inshallah. Hamid al-Islam, jazakallah khair for your recitation and beautiful speech. Inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give barakah in your life, inshallah. Jazakallah khair.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Respected viewers, Alhamdulillah, we are listening to beautiful recitations from our contestants so far. Alhamdulillah, we had beautiful recitations, and the time is going so quickly. So we'll be calling upon our next contestant, Nasiruddin, from London.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Nasiruddin, how are you today?
Alhamdulillah.
MashaAllah, nice smile. Sadaqa jariya in the smile. MashaAllah. What surah you've chosen for the recitation?
Surah Al-Najm.
Surah Al-Najm, MashaAllah. Okay, you've got 7 minutes for the recitation. Then after that, the judges will ask you the question. You can begin when you're ready.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والنجم إذا هوى ما ضل صاحبكم وما غوى وما ينطق عن الهوى إن هو إلا وحي يوحى علمه شديد القوى ذو مرة فاستوى وهو بالأفق الأعلى ثم دنا فتدلى فكان قاب قوسين أو أدنى فأوحى إلى عبده ما أوحى ما كذب الفؤاد ما رأى أفتمارونه على ما يرى ولقد رآه نزلة أخرى عند سدرة المنتهى عندها جنة المأوى إذ يغشى السدرة ما يغشى ما زاغ البصر وما طغى لقد رأى من آيات ربه الكبرى أفرأيتم اللات والعزى ومناة الثالثة الأخرى ألكم الذكر وله الأنثى تلك إذا قسمة ضيزى إن هي إلا أسماء سميتموها أنتم أنتم وآباؤكم ما أنزل الله بها من سلطان إن يتبعون إلا الظن وما تهوى الأنفس ولقد جاءهم من ربهم الهدى أم للإنسان ما تمنى فلله الآخرة والأولى وكم من ملك في السماوات لا تغني شفاعتهم شيئا لا تغني شفاعتهم شيئا إلا من بعد أن يأذن الله لمن يشاء ويرضى إن الذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة ليسمون الملائكة ليسمون الملائكة تسمية الأنثى وما لهم به من علم إن يتبعون إلا الظن وإن الظن لا يغني من الحق شيئا فأعرض عمن تولى عن ذكرنا ولم يرد إلا الحياة الدنيا ذلك مبلغهم من العلم إن ربك هو أعلم بمن ضل عن سبيله وهو أعلم بمن اهتدى ولله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض ليجزي الذين أساءوا بما عملوا ويجزي الذين أحسنوا بالحسنى الذين يجتنبون كبائر الإثم والفواحش إلا اللمم إن ربك واسع المغفرة هو أعلم بكم إذ أنشأكم من الأرض وإذ أنتم أجنة في بطون أمهاتكم فلا تزكوا أنفسكم هو أعلم بمن اتقى أفرأيت الذي تولى وأعطى قليلا وأكدى أعنده علم الغيب فهو يرى أم لم ينبأ بما في صحف موسى وإبراهيم الذي وفى ألا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى وأن ليس للإنسان إلا ما سعى وأن سعيه سوف يرى ثم يجزاه الجزاء الأوفى وأن إلى ربك المنتهى وأنه هو أضحك وأبكى وأنه هو أمات وأحيا وأنه خلق الزوجين الذكر والأنثى من نطفة إذا تمنى وأن عليه النشأة الأخرى وأنه هو رب الشعرى وأنه أهلك عادن الأولى وثمود فما أبقى وقوم نوح من قبل إنهم كانوا هم أظلم وأطغى والمؤتفكة أهوى فغشاها ما غشى فبأي آلاء ربك تتمارى هذا نذير من النذر الأولى أزفت الآزفة ليس لها من دون الله كاشفة أفمن هذا الحديث تعجبون وتضحكون ولا تبكون وأنتم سامدون فاسجدوا لله واعبدوا صدق الله العظيم
أحسن جزاك الله خير may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your recitation before I go to the question I will ask Sheikh Qadi Lutfur Rahman to explain to our audience the viewers about the last verse what he recited about the sajda so what is the ruling regarding if someone listen to this
Yes. Hanafi school, we should do a sijda, inshallah.
Yes.
It's a wajib. No. But just because we're going to delay, so we'll say, Sami'na wa ta'na, wafranaka rabbana, wa ilayka al-masir. And then we'll do it later on, inshallah.
Inshallah. So, viewers and everyone here, we should make sure that we do this sijda, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. So, I'll go to the judges for them to ask you four questions, inshallah. I would start with Sheikh Qadi Lutfur Rahman yes. for you to say the first question.
Yeah, mashallah. For a while, you sounded like Sheikh Abdul Wali Arkani. Mashallah, beautiful recitation. If you can just say, فَأَعْرِضْ عَمَّنْ فَأَعْرِضْ عَمَّنْ تَوَلَّى So, just فَأَعْرِضْ عَمَّنْ I just want that to be
just the whole section.
Yeah, just فأعرض.
So the thought obviously will be read as full mouth.
Okay.
فأعرض.
Yeah.
عمن.
Do you know the sifa in bod? Like
yeah, the bod is the back of the tongue yeah. upturned when yeah. touching the roots of the yeah. either side of the premolars. Yeah.
This makhraj, the sifa, like sifa. The quality.
It's a full mouth would be isti'ala.
Okay. Yes, isti'ala or isti'ala. Yeah. But when you say فأعرض.
Mm.
Don't just if أعرض عن من تولى. فأعرض عن.
With a bit of flow.
Yeah, bit of flow. جزاكم الله خيرا.
بارك الله فيك شيخ. أستاذ محمد بدر, your question إن شاء الله.
So in the verse in here إلا أسماء سميتموها. So in here.
In here would be إصهار.
Could you explain to me what that is?
إصهار is after نون ساكنة تنوين. If any letters apart. From basically any of the throat letters appear, then you'll read the noon clearly, distinctly.
And asma'un.
Asma'un is a mad muttasil due to the alif, which a hamza came after in the same word.
Length.
The length would be some say either 3 to 5 or 4 to 6. So.
Okay. And un sammaytumuha.
Asma'un, that's a ikhfa. After the tanween of the hamza, there came a sin, which is one of the 15 letters of ikhfa. And what you do would, in this case, would be the tanween to be read with the ikhfa sound, not complete gunna, but slightly read from the nose.
What does the word ikhfa mean?
Ikhfa means to cover up.
Okay,
jazakallah khair. Ustad Anhar Ahmed.
Okay, can you please tell me the makhraj of the letter dha?
It's at the tip of the tongue when touching the edge of the teeth. When. Edge of the front two teeth, sorry.
Okay.
Okay, inshallah. Jazakallah khair. One more question by Shaykh Qadil al-Rahman.
Kaba'ir al-Ladin yajtanibuna kaba'ir. What's the ruling there? Kaba'ir?
Kaba'ir is a mutti muttasil.
Okay. It should be longer. When you recite, also make it long. Kaba'ir al-Ladin.
Okay, JazakAllah khair, our judges, and JazakAllah khair, Nasiruddin. We have to go to short break. We'll come after the break for your speech, inshallah. Respected viewers, we are going to short break. Make sure you stay tuned with us. We're coming back soon. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
يا